some of the unsung heroes, I think, in our public school system and in our city school system is our school counselors. And I'm here today with Melba Holloway. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So let's talk for a minute about what it's like a day in your shoes, a day as a student, or I guess a student counselor is the same thing as a school counselor?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Well, it's varied. I teach some classes to sixth graders. It's called psychoeducation, mm-hmm. but classes on gratitude, conflict resolution, study skills, those sorts of things. Also, I do the same for seventh graders. Right now, we're helping the eighth graders get their four-year high school plans together and starting to have early conversations about what they might want to do when they get older. Mm-hmm. I do small group counseling, so it may be topic-oriented, like counseling about divorce or any kind of change or transition. And then also individual counseling and a lot of outreach and a little bit of public relations as well.
So tell me what might be one of your favorite things about your job.
One of my favorite things really is going into the classroom because I don't really teach any academic subjects, but I do teach those integral life skills. And so that's the way I get to kind of had laugh with the children, bond with the children, kind of know what's going on in their world, mm-hmm. and see them all at the same time. So that's one of my favorite things.
Okay, so let's talk for just a moment about maybe some things that parents can do at home to help their children be more successful while they're at school.
Okay, well, I think it's important, of course, to know who your children's friends are.
Amen. I may be old-fashioned, but I think that just doesn't go out of style.
Yes, and also know their parents. I know personally, I have a child who now has some friends who are older since he's in high school and he's now with children who can drive. So while in middle school, that may not be the case, but it's important to know who's driving your children and of course, who's in the homes that they're visiting. Also monitoring social media use, limiting that time, limiting the video game time. Finding some time to have a family dinner or a meal where you sit down with your child and talk about things that are important, or maybe even in the car when you're going somewhere, asking not just how was your day, because they can kind of give a closed-ended answer, mm-hmm. but specifically what did you do, what did you eat, who did you see, who were in your classes. We also need to change the conversation that we have with children about drugs, because the trends in drug use are changing. Children now are using Juuling, which is the e-cigarettes. I think it's almost marketed to children because the nicotine comes in flavors,
the fruit scents.
Fruit scents.
I've seen something about that recently.
Right, and I don't think children understand mm-hmm. that it's not, you know, just kind of vapor.
Right.
They think it's flavored vapor, but yes. It actually is pure nicotine. It might not have the cancer-causing elements of a cigarette, but nicotine goes to the brain in 4 seconds, and it's still addictive.
So if there are parents that are watching us today and they have a middle schooler that goes to Pelham Park, if there is something they're concerned about, can they contact you directly?
Oh, definitely so.
Okay. Can you give your email address for that? Is that okay?
Sure.
Okay.
It is mdholloway@pelhamcityschools.org.
Okay. And anything that they could contact you about would just range from anything that they feel like their child's struggling with?
Or, sure.
Okay.
Social, emotional, mm-hmm. And academic needs. So I sometimes I'm a go-between to help set up conferences or attend conferences. And email, I'm a little faster with email than phone, so that's a great way to contact me.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, we sure appreciate your time today. Thank you so much.
Well, thank you for coming and talking with me.
Happy New Year.
Same to you.